In this video, I want to quickly bring to you update of Sotito Bires trial that is still ongoing and in Akure on those days. Recall that I promise you that I will bring you every update as they happen. And yesterday was the continuation of the defense trial, and it was the fourth sitting that took place for the defense. And you know from past videos that the defense already have 5 witnesses who have testified, and yesterday was the 6th witness who happened to be Sotito Bires himself. Yeah, Sotito Bires testified in court in defense of himself. Hello everybody, how you are doing? Welcome back to another video on my channel. I really hope that your week is ongoing very fine. So I just want to bring you the update of the trial of Sotito Bires, Afa Babatunde Sotito Bires, that is still continuing in Akure Ondo State. So you know we have been coming along and following this case, and it was scheduled to start again 14th of July 2020, and that was yesterday. So they actually sat in court yesterday, and you know, if you've been following me, you know that they've already had 3 sittings of the defense, and yesterday was the 4th defense court sitting that the defense had to present their witnesses. And you know that the defense have already brought 5 witnesses in the past. So yesterday was Sotito Bires himself. Yes, Sotito Bires himself came to testify to the court to exonerate himself in defense of himself. So yeah, I welcome every one of you who is joining me for the first time. Please go ahead and hit that subscribe button and also enable the notification so I get you notified whenever I upload a new video. Thank you so much if you did that. And I'd like to say thank you also to every one of you who already subscribed. Thank you so much. I really appreciate you. So moving on quickly, without wasting your time, I will just say that if you have not been following me on this channel, or if you don't know the last proceedings, you can just check this link here. I put a playlist there, and I also put dates on the video, so it's very easy for you to filter through the videos to know exactly which update you'll be more interested in. Yeah, so Sotito Bires testified in court yesterday for himself, in defense of himself, and he basically told the court that he doesn't know anything about what happened to the baby, and that the DSS have arrested him and his church members. They've gone to his house and searched it. They did not find anything. They've gone to his church and searched it. They did not find anything. And he did all he could within his powers to help in finding the baby by organizing marathon, night vigil, and prayer sessions. And him and his church members, they were participating and praying to God to help them to recover the baby. And he's disappointed that the parents of the baby did not cooperate with him. You remember in one of my last videos, you heard him saying that he told them to come through the proper channel, and they refused to come through the proper channel. So that's what he was saying there now, that they did not cooperate with him. So when they asked him what exactly is this proper channel that he's talking about, he said the proper channel is also praying, that they supposed to come and join in the prayers, and then also involve the security personnel. But we know that the parents are actually the ones that initiated the involvement of the police. And we also know that because of his influence, the Akure, the local police did not do anything, or did not actually get involved as much as you would expect them, until the people came in from Abuja. So anyway, this is just his own defense for himself. He said the parents of the boy did not cooperate with him as much as he wanted to help them, and he went ahead to hold the prayers and prayer sessions with his church members. And his lawyer presented video evidence of the church service that he held to that effect, where they were praying to God to help them to recover the baby. And then he also said that he doesn't know this couple because there are so many people in his church, and that even though the couple said that they have been coming to his church since June. I don't know if you remember, but the mom of this boy said they started going to this church in June. So, and this thing happened in November, so barely 5 months that they started going into this church, you know, this disappearance happened. And Sotito Bires said he doesn't know them, and he only got to know them when this thing happened. So Sotito Bires just basically said that he doesn't know this couple, and he has never seen them before until this incident happened, that he didn't know them. So I don't know how true that is, you know, because the mother said something that when it was found out that yeah, it was her baby that was missing, that he was saying something like, ah, kubama je, or something like that, like it shouldn't have been his son, like suggesting that he knew him. But anyway, this is what he said in defense of himself. So when they started to cross-examine him, they also asked him if indeed it was true that the local police people did not really get involved until the DSS came. He said yes, you know, among other questions that they were asking him. Anyways, the lawyers of Sotitobire are very, very happy with the testimony that he has given, and they also are happy with the cross-examination, and they have confidence in the defense that they have presented so far. And I'll just let you hear what they have to say.
He explained what happened in the church and how the DSS and other went to his house, went to his church, and they found nothing incriminating against him. He also explained to the hearing of the court, and you were also there, all the steps that he took, how he ensured that there was any report of the incident to the police, and how, of course, announcements were made in different radio stations to ensure that the missing child was found.
Yeah, you hear what the lawyer said. But the chief prosecutor also have something else to say. He said that they made Sotitobire to understand the case that they have against him. They presented their witnesses, their evidence, and everything. And it's left for the judge to decide based on the strength of the evidence that he has before him. So yeah, he's also happy with his own prosecution and how far he has gone. So I'll just let you listen to him also.
This evidence is eluded. We tried our best possible to at least let him know that we have a case against him. That's the beauty of advocacy. He monitored what he knew, and we confronted him with some documentary evidence. So the long and short of it is for the judge now to weigh his evidence vis-a-vis the one we have against him.
So my people, you've heard it all. You've heard what both sides of them have to say. And unfortunately for me, if you ask me, I will say I feel very disappointed, because up until now, we still don't hear anything about the baby. We don't even know if the police are still looking for the baby, or if there is some concluding part that they're just kind of stuck in this prosecution. I don't know. And I don't still understand why they are holding back those people who took care of that baby, who came in contact with the baby and the mother on that day. I don't know why they are still not proceeding with those people. So we just have to wait and see what evidence that they still have. I mean, in defense of Sotitobire, because the defense is continuing today as we are talking. So we'll see who they brought again as a witness, you know, because I feel that they are kind of dancing around the whole thing, because they are not bringing the most important witness, you know. Of course, on that day, I would assume that Sotitobire was on the altar, except of course there's evidence that at some point he left that altar, or perhaps we can hear from those people who took care of the children if they got a directive from him at some point. You know, I think that they're just kind of going in circles. I feel that something is still missing, and I'm not happy. I can say that I'm not just happy. I'm just kind of following this thing. I feel some kind of frustration. And I don't know how the parents are feeling right now, because I don't know what they want to achieve with this kind of prolongation of the whole thing. But anyway, I'll just continue to bring you the update, and we'll continue to see how it goes. Like I said, the trial continues today. So this update I'm bringing you is the one that happened yesterday, the 14th. So tomorrow, by the grace of God, I'm going to bring you the update of whatever they said today, and who the defense presented as a witness, you know. So I'm also looking forward to those people who are co-accused with him, because I believe there are also those people who were, you know, in the crash. So I would expect that at some point that they will also give some defense for themselves in the court. So yeah, let's just keep our fingers crossed. Like I always say, let's continue to reach out in our heart for the parents and everyone involved, that God will not allow this justice to be delayed, and that it should not that God will just not allow this justice to just continuously be delayed like this, and that, yeah, justice will just prevail. That's just my take. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you like this video. Give it a thumbs up, and yeah, subscribe and join me here. Thank you so much, and I'll see you very soon in another video. Bye for now. Bye.